listen to some of it, but not all of it. And I think the judges asked good questions, you know, to the state and to Brendan's lawyers. So I'm hoping they're more on Brendan's side than the state side, but
it's a different state, different people, so it's more hopeful. Mm-hmm. Being here in the state of Wisconsin, it's...
Well, if it was in the state of Wisconsin, there would be no chance.
Best guess is that it will take between 6 months and a year for the Seventh Circuit to rule.
The Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals is being asked to decide whether Judge Duffin was right or wrong. Either Judge Duffin was right, this conviction should be overturned and that confession should be thrown out, or the district court was wrong. Brendan should stay in prison.
Does not have to be a unanimous decision. There were three judges on that panel, and whoever can command two votes will win this round. If we win, our next step will be to seek an appeal bond that would enable Brendan to be released while this case to drag its way through the courts. First step is to try to get the entire Seventh Circuit, all of the judges, to hear the case. If the Seventh Circuit decides it does not want to hear the case, there's one more step in the process, and that's asking the United States Supreme Court to review the decisions of the Seventh Circuit. Either way, win or lose, Laura and I will keep fighting until we're out of cards to try to get Brendan home and back with his family.
Hey, the water on there today?
Yeah. There's the heater by 6 feet with a handle gator and a zero better on your head.
No?
Yeah, there's most of the special gets on their phones. Especially just the ice and sheep on the rice.
Again?
Yeah, because people throw up their pictures.
Does go the wrong way, well, then I think they're all in. So it's 11:10 a.m. Monday. They were barking for 2 minutes because someone was walking down the trail. But by the time I got the phone out and started recording, they stopped. We've been recording for 4 minutes now.
Did you leave early that morning? Okay. Before you went to work or in here?
I called
I'll trade her that morning.
Good girl, go lay down. Minion, lay down. Good girl.
Of the prosecution that Teresa was lured by Stephen Avery to that property.
The state's theory was that Stephen was this sex-obsessed maniac who lured Teresa to his property to kill her after setting an appointment with her, and that he was using deception by calling and using the name B. Yonda. The truth is, she knew where she was going. At 2:27, she told Don Plitzker at Otter